Let us look at this learning by recording cases a little bit more closely. Implicit in our discussion so far has been the notion of most similar or most closely resembling. But how can we operationalize it? How can we make it more explicit? So once again, here is the world of various colored blocks. And we can represent these various blocks, back to the notion of knowledge representation, we can represent our knowledge of these various blocks in a two-dimensional grid, the width of the block and the height of the block. So the blue block may lie here, the red block here, and so on. So when a new problem comes along, we may represent it on the same two-dimensional grid. In this particular case, the new problem may be represented at this particular dot. Now, given all the cases and the new problem, we may calculate the distance between the new problem to each of the previous known cases. Once we have calculated the distance between the new problem and each of the previous cases, we can simply select the case which is closest to the new problem. This method is called the nearest neighbor method. Now we need a way of calculating the distance between a problem and a case. One measure of the distance is called the Euclidean distance. Here is the formula for the Euclidean distance. The Euclidean distance between two points, x of c and y of c, which define the case, and the x of n and the y of n, which define the problem, is given by this formula. Now we can easily calculate the Euclidean distance between each of the cases and the new problem, and this table summarizes the distances. Given this table, we can very quickly see that the case of the black block is closest to the new problem, and therefore one might give the answer that the new block is also black in color. So the nearest neighbor method is one method of finding the most similar case or the most closely resembling case.